Yes, this is a review of my Reader's Digest RDA 127 radio receiver. It is a 1970s era radio with a lot of bells and whistles, and I really love it, and I'm just going to showcase it here with a lot of other radios to show you how neat and way ahead of their time these radios used to be. This particular radio has a shortwave, CB, AM, FM, TV1, TV2, air traffic, weather band, and police band. You would be able to get that way back then, if you can imagine. So here's the video.
Thank you. in sight, one and one. Josh had a big year last year. Back out in on him. 2023 off to a quick start, but then really cooled off. Lost planes on to both Longoria and Rivera. There's a sock fly ball in the shallow center.
Under the altar, the souls of them that were slain, God, and for the testimony which they held, and they cried with a loud voice, saying, How long, O Lord, holy and true, dost thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? And white robes were given unto every one of them, and it was said unto them that they had rest yet for a little season, until their fellow servants also and their brethren that should be killed as they should be fulfilled. And I beheld, when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood, and the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casteth her untimely figs when she is shaken of a mighty wind. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island were moved out of their places. And the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man, hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, Fall on us, and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb.
Did say hello, and push you low in that five and keep it all the way live. I'm going to turn this attention back down toward the south, man, and look around the Big Horn and Arizona and all that, too. Get the antenna down around the, about the 100-degree mark somewhere around there. Load them out small, even in stepping like that down.
Over there, it's hot all over the country, you know, it's definitely different. It's warmer than usual over here on our neck of the woods, too, and definitely climate change is real. Now, one thing I'm going to argue with, though, and I don't want to start a big old thing over here, I'm going to argue that I had a lot of different opinions, and it's kind of like politics and religion, but I'm going to say it anyway.
Once I 17 years, the Bible back, you can never, you know, hear you. Right there, right back, I got you.
Contributing, and I'm not going to say we're not contributing, but it's still about every 100,000 year cycle, you know, it's a cycle, that the planet goes through on its own, so we're not the overall cause of it, so I don't feel so bad when I run this great big old hammer. Oh, it was 517, mode of my man, but you're right, the climate change is real.
Well,
Pat, I don't know if you can hear me on channel 23. Turn up that little voice. Channel 23.
All right, so it is Sunday, July 30th, 2023, in the year of our Lord. I'm going to do a review on these communication radios, emergency radios, prepper radios, whatever you want to call them. Good radios, old ones and new ones. I'm going to just basically test the distance on them. So I bought this off of Amazon a few days ago. DC to AC converter. Excuse me, AC to DC converter. And these handheld units are, we run on DC power. So you have a Midland. This is an old-fashioned one. That's an old-fashioned one. This is a General Electric. That's probably 70s. This 70s or 80s. This is a newer one. Uniden. Cobra. And an E-Ready Midland brand. Okay. So let me get this thing out of this bag here. Show you this little pouch contains this CB radio, which came with this antenna here. You can see that antenna all in that little pouch. 1970 stuff. Look at this. Owner's manual, still got it. Came with the DC charger for your car. And here's the radio. Here's the CB radio. I love these old radios. I love radio in general. And that's what this video is all about. Yeah. Okay. So, I'm going to get this all set up. And I'm going to use this as the base station. Oh, no. I'll use that one as the base station. Now use this and the unit in there to see how far long distance these will transmit to here. Okay, so let me set up all this stuff and then we'll go from there. Okay, as you can see, I have it on channel 14. I'm going to have it connected to my car cigarette lighter. This is one of the old CBs. I'm going to test, just to give it a quick test. See, it keeps going. The cable, got to make sure the cable is in there good. So, see, you can see the antenna that comes with it for car. It's not made to be portable like the unit in here, so I'm going to give it a, like I said, a quick test. It's on channel 14, so I'm going to go quite a distance here walking, and then I'm going to try a different thing with it, but you'll see.
Okay, quick test. Hope you can hear this.
probably like 25 yards away right here. I'm about 100 yards away, so I hope you can hear this, at least for my sake. Like I said, I'm going to do a test on these to see how far the ranges actually can go.
Okay, hopefully that one went through, because it is damn hot out here. So now I'm going to switch it to this one, another old 70s car CB. So let me just switch out the wires to this one. First, turn it off. Put that aside. This is the Midland. There. Turn it on. Oops. This one might be a little difficult. Okay, channel 14 again. So here I go again at the 50 yard mark and then at the 100 yard mark.
I'm at the 50-yard mark here. Hope you can hear me. I'm not wasting my time here like an idiot out in the hot sun. 50-yard mark. Heading to the 100-yard mark now. Just to be sure, 100-yard mark again. 123. Heading back to the car right now.
All right, so this part of the test hopefully went through. I won't know until I review this video, but I'll just show you the setup again. Those are the two it's 1970s era CB radios, which I really like. The only thing I don't like about them is that they're just made for cars, where you use the old-fashioned cigarette lighter, and it comes, both of them came with the antenna, but I only have one, and that's the antenna right there. You can see, you put it in your car, on top of your car, and then you attach it to your area radio there. All right, so we're gonna do something different here. So let me set up something here where I'm going to test, turn this off, this one. I'm going to put this by itself because it's portable battery, remember? So, and you know, the batteries don't last long on those. You know, it takes 9 batteries, but you know, it's only 5 watt, it'll use them all up real quick, so I don't got too much battery power left probably. But anyway, so I want to go far on the car to transmit to the unit in to test the talk power, the transmit power I should say, on the two car radios to the portable CB there. And so yeah, let me get set up here. All right, so I'm gonna leave this right here, and I'm gonna drive 5 miles away and see what I can transmit to from those old CBs to this one, 5 miles away.
information is written through to the unit in. Again, this is the old General Electric handheld. Hopefully this signal is getting through. Over and out.